Hi guys, welcome back to math class with Miss Brown. In today's class, we will be dividing fractions, right? So as you can see, we have 1/3 divided by 1/2, right? And I have it written twice because I'm going to show you two different ways we can solve it. The first way is we can cross multiply. I know you're probably like, what? I just thought you said we were going to divide, but you'll see what I mean. And then the second time, we are going to flip the fractions, right? We're gonna flip the fraction and multiply. So let's get started on the first one. So we have 1/3 divided by 1/2. Remember I said cross multiply. So when we cross multiply, we're just gonna cross multiply. We see the 1 and a 2 and then the 1 and a 3 diagonally, right? But before we cross multiply, you have to keep in mind that you have to multiply, even though you see a division symbol there, right? So 1 times 2 is 2. And then 1 times 3 is 3. So technically you're switching the division symbol into a multiplication symbol and then you cross multiply, if that makes sense. Does it? Okay, remember, cross multiplication. Change the symbol and then cross multiply, okay? So now let's look at the second one. Again, we have 1/3 divided by 1/2, right? And in this case, we are going to keep the first fraction like it is, the 1/3. And then you see that division symbol, we are going to change it into a multiplication symbol. But then the second fraction, 1/2, we're going to flip it. So the 1 is at the top, the 2 is at the bottom. We're just going to flip it and put the 2 at the top and the 1 at the bottom. And there you go. So we're just going to multiply, right? 1 times 2 is 2, and then 3 times 1 is 3. Does that make sense, guys? I know at the first one at the top, we cross multiply and you're wondering, well, why didn't we cross multiply at the bottom? Well, we cross multiplied at the top is because we changed the symbol, right? We changed the symbol, so that's why we had to cross multiply. The bottom one, we changed the symbol, but then we also flipped the bottom. Does that make sense? Let's look at another one. Okay, so now in this one, let's do 3/4 divided by, let's say 2/5. 3/4 divided by 2/5. I'm going to write that again because we're going to do it two different ways. Even if it seems confusing to you now, the more you practice, the better you will become. You guys know that I am a firm believer of that. The more practice you guys do or get, you are going to get better, okay? So we have 3/4 divided by 2/5. Remember, we are going to cross multiply at the top first, right? But before we cross multiply, we're going to change the division symbol into a multiplication symbol, okay? So always remember that. Even if you keep the division symbol the same, just always have it in your head that you are going to multiply. So let's cross multiply. 3 times 5 is 15, and then 2 times 4 is 8. Now we have 15/8. What do we know about this fraction? This fraction is an improper fraction. If you need to learn how to solve an improper fraction to make it into a mixed number, please go check out my video. I do have a video on that. But we will get 1 7/8, okay? You guys are probably wondering, well, how do we get 1 7/8? Go check out that video on how to work with improper fractions and you guys will see. So now at the bottom, we keep the first fraction the same, 3/4. We change the division symbol into a multiplication symbol. And then the second fraction, we flip it. We flip it, right? So we're going to flip it. The 2 is going to go at the bottom and a 5 is going to go at the top. So now we are going to multiply straight across. 3 times 5 is 15 and 4 times 8 is 4 times 2, I'm sorry, is 8. And we got 15/8, just like the top one. And then 15/8, that's an improper fraction. And then you'll get 1 7/8. Don't forget to check out the video on improper fractions so you guys can understand and know how to change an improper fraction. Okay, guys, so I know it's a lot. But let's just do another one, okay? All right, let's go. So let's say 4/10 divided by, let's say 4/10 divided by 5/7, okay? 5/7, yeah. So remember, I'm going to write it twice so I can show you both of the different ways, okay? So 4/10 divided by 5/7. So the top one, remember, even if we don't change the division symbol, but always keep it in your brain that it needs to change to a multiplication symbol, right? So the division symbol changed to a multiplication symbol, and then we cross multiply. That's the first way. So 4 times 7 and then 5 times 10. All right, 4 times 7 is 28 and 5 times 10 is 50. Okay. All right. What do we know about this fraction? It's not an improper fraction, but it can be simplified, guys. It can be simplified. So if you just ask yourself, well, how do I simplify this, right? Well, we're not going to get into that. Go watch my video on how to simplify a fraction. But when we simplify 28/50, we get 14/25, okay? If you want to know how I did that, go check out the video on how to simplify, okay? So now, let's do the bottom one. 4 tenths divided by 5/7. So remember, we changed the division symbol and we flipped the second fraction. So we changed the division symbol to a multiplication and then we flipped the second fraction. At the top, we only changed the symbol, cross multiplied the bottom. We changed the symbol and flipped the second fraction. So as you guys can see, I got 28/50, and when we simplify that, we get 14/25, just like the top, same exact answers, okay? So remember, check out the videos on improper fractions and how to simplify, okay? I hope you guys had a fun time in today's class, and I'll see you next time. Bye.